Hello guys, and welcome back to our channel. Charger Lab has gotten an Apple 12W USB-A charger, which is the only Apple charger supporting the 5V 2.4A protocol. Let's take it apart. The front of the packaging is printed with the Apple logo, the product name, and the picture. In the back, you can see the usage, the CE mark, and the product names in several languages. The parameter is on the side. The packaging includes the charger and the manual. The charger has a classic square design with a white PC casing and rounded edges. It's equipped with the foldable prongs. The removable plug makes it easy for users to change to meet different needs. The metal button can be connected to the ground wire. The gray shell of the plug is printed with the 2.5A, 250V, and the manufacturer name. The USB-A port is white. The size is about 46x46x28mm. The weight is about 66 grams. The ChargerLab Power ZKT002 finds that the USB-A port supports the Apple 2.4A protocol. Okay, let's see what's inside. First, take apart the shell and take out the PCBA module. As you can see, the isolation plate used for insulation corresponds to where the USB-A receptacle is. The metal button that solders wire is for grounding. The primary filter capacitor and transformer are wrapped with insulation tape, and the plastic sheet is inserted between the USB-A receptacle and the transformer to strengthen the insulation. The AC input receptacle stampings a fixed metal piece and solders the wire to the PCBA module. The input wire and cold press terminal are covered with the heat shrink tool and soldered to the PCBA module. The transformer is insulated by tape and fixed with adhesive. The PCB slotting and isolation board insulate the primary circuit from the secondary circuit. Then, let's analyze the components one by one. The fuse resistor is externally wrapped with black tape for insulation and overcurrent protection. The common mode choke from Sumida is surrounded by a magnet ring and wrapped with external insulation tape. Two high voltage filter capacitors from Nippon Chemicon are for the primary filter and support 400 volts 12 microfarads. This is the differential mode choke between the two capacitors, whose pin is covered by an insulation tube. The primary master control chip marked with 601A is in QFN package. The primary switch transistor is from Infineon IPS-A0R1K4P7, marked with A0R1K4P7, belonging to the QMOS P7 series. It's an NMOS with the withstand voltage of 800 volts, resistor of 1.4 ohms, and package of IPAK-SL, namely the 2251. The Sumida OEM transformer's date code is 2143. Two white capacitors are stacked together, and one of them is insulated with a heat shrink tube on its pins. The L217SMD optocoupler is for output voltage feedback. The synchronous rectifier from Osemi, marked with 658L, is an NMOS with a withstand voltage of 60 volts, resistor of 5 milliohms, and the WDFNA package. The DCMO synchronous rectifier controller from Osemi, marked with ACD, supports the maximum operating frequency of 200 kHz. The output solid filter capacitor is 1200 microfarads, 6.3 volts. The serial number of the charger is on the inside of the USB-A receptacle. Well, that's all for the teardown of the Apple 12W USB-A charger A2167. Even this charger used a synchronous rectifier back in the day. It was still not popular. It supports 5V 2.4A and can reach the maximum output power of the charger when charging for the devices with a lightning cable. To be honest, it's not bad. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!